My wife and I did that last night for you, so.
Oh, thank you so much.
But it was all just in a bag, like a grocery bag, I guess.
Yeah. So. Oh, look at what you did. Wow. Oh my gosh, that's his dad. It's my grandfather.
Oh, your grandfather?
Yes.
I was wondering who that was.
Cuties.
Oh. I thought they were probably related.
Yeah.
You can see the resemblance.
Yeah. This is such a treasure, Jeff. I can't believe it was in the...
And you've never seen these items, have you?
No. When he left, there wasn't a lot that he left behind.
Right.
He didn't have a lot of pictures of him. And of course, this stuff, we had no idea.
Yeah, and I was, I think your other sister had said that you didn't know that, didn't think he had even left the U.S.
That's what she had heard. We all kind of had our own ideas of what he did.
Well, it doesn't say a lot on his DD-214. Other than his training for some reason. But if you'll look and you'll see in there that he flew so many missions, combat missions against the Japanese enemy. So,
wow.
Yeah.
The only thing I knew about his military, my mom had written in my baby book that he was in the Pacific during World War II. That's, that's all I ever knew.
Yeah. This is gonna answer a lot of questions for you.
Yeah.
And that's from Farstall, Admiral Farstall, I believe that one is.
Just, oh, he was in Memphis. Wow.
Yep, he was at the air base there. That's where he did his aviation training. Aviation mechanics mate is what he was.
So. Yeah. My one sister, who was the one who talked to Doug, she thought he was just a mechanic. I thought he was in the bombers where they had the glass ball on the bottom.
Deterrence,
I thought he was in that. My brother thought he was a pilot.